Hello, class 11. Today we will continue with our fourth chapter, that is apparatus of state, nature and apparatus of states. There we will see Ziauddin Barani's Fatwa e Jahandari. We have already done the Arthashastra by Kautilya. There we have seen in ancient India what were the apparatus, main apparatus of states, or what were the main subject matter of Kautilya's Arthashastra. Today we will see the main subject matter of Ziauddin Barani's Fatwa-e-Jahandari. And there we will see, according to Barani, what are the main characteristics of state or what are the main apparatus of state. So first of all, we should remember that Ziauddin Barani was born in 1283 and he was the court author till 1359. So he was born in Baran actually, that is why he is known as Ziauddin Barani. And what we see is that he was a very famous court author during that time, and he was there mainly during the time of Muhammad bin Tughlaq. Also after Muhammad bin Tughlaq, during Firuz Shah Tughlaq also Ziauddin Barani was the author of the court, and he wrote about the accounts of mainly Firuz Shah's administration. Also some account of Muhammad bin Tughlaq's administration we get from Ziauddin Barani's writing. So what we see is that his most famous work is this one, that is Fatwa-e-Jahandari. This is the most famous work of Barani, from which we get the idea of the nature of state during the Delhi Sultanate. Also apart from these, other than this one, he has also written other works like Tariq-e-Firuzshahi, from which we get a little account of administration during the time of Firuz Shah. Also, he has written Tariq-e-Barmiki, which is another of the famous work of Ziauddin Barani. But mostly as this book, Fatwa-e-Jahandari, is the most famous and popular book of Ziauddin Barani. We will deal with this book, we will discuss about this book, and we will see what we can know about the nature of state during the Delhi Sultanate from this book. So what we see is that in his book, Barani had discussed given emphasis to two particular facts. One is the theory of kingship, this one he has given emphasis in his book Fatwa-e-Jahandari. Another part where he has given emphasis is the nobility. These are the two things which he has dealt in detail in his book Fatwa-e-Jahandari. So in the theory of kingship, he has clearly said, Ziauddin Barani has clearly said about the divine right of kingship. So he is saying that the king is the representative of God, and as he is a representative of God, he has to take any decision which suits him, and the people cannot question him in the matter of the laws and order. So the king is the supreme and he can take any decision, he can pass any law. And we see that during the Delhi Sultanate, this philosophy or this theory of divine right of kingship, that is king is the representative of God, this theory was very much prevalent. Also he said that the sultan should be noble born. That is also another important factor or nature of the state according to Barani, that sultan should be noble born, of high birth. So here what we see is that in the theory of kingship, he also mentions that monarchy is not acceptable in Islam, but if the need of the day is monarchy, then monarchy is acceptable. So what he is trying to say is that according to Islamic law, monarchy is not acceptable, but if the situation is such where only a monarchical form of government can function, then the king can become monarch. That is, he can hold the power hereditarily, he can hold the power with autocracy. So what we see is that these are the basic principle, basic theory of kingship during the Sultanate. Apart from these, we also see that it was a rule, that Sharia was there. Sharia too was the Islamic law. So it was the rule that the king, whoever is the king or the ruler, basically ruled the state following the Shariat. But what you see is that when the Sultanate was ruling in the Delhi Sultanate, Zawahit was one of the law which was formed by the king. The rulers framed a different law from that of the Shariat. So the rulers are not exactly following the Shariat for ruling the Indian state, but they are framing a different set of law, that is the Zawahit. So in this case, so as they are not following the Shariat fully, Shariat is the religious injunctions, and the Delhi Sultanate and the rulers, the nobles, they are making a separate set of law for ruling India. That is why Ziauddin Barani is saying that the Sultanate rule, during the Sultanate rule, it was not theocracy. Theocracy was not there. Now the question may come to your mind that what is theocracy? Theocracy means basically a state which is ruled by religious law. So what we see is that during the Sultanate, they were of course following Islamic law, but they were not strictly following all the Islamic law for ruling the state, because we know that India India was a Hindu majority country. So when they were ruling this country, they are not blindly following the injunctions of Shariat. Rather, they are making a new set of law. The king or the ruler or the sultan, they are making a new set of law, that is the Zawahit, and from based on that they are ruling the state. So Ziauddin Barani has clearly mentioned under the theory of kingship that the Delhi Sultanate was not a theocratic state. Theocracy was not there, that is, the state was not ruled based on religious principle, but it was somehow a secular state. Apart from these, we see that king was the supreme head. That was the main theory of kingship under the Delhi Sultanate. Then we can move on to the nobility, where we see that Ziauddin Barani is saying that for selecting the nobles, the king or the sultan should be very careful. And the nobles should be selected from people of high birth, that is of noble birth. Also, the king should keep spy or espionage system to take information about the nobles, what the nobles are doing, whether they are functioning properly or not. For all this, the king should keep a spy or a group of espionage. So what we see is that under the nobility, Ziauddin Barani is clearly stating that the king should be very careful in selecting the nobles, because it is the nobles, the nobility will help the king in ruling the state, because king alone cannot rule the state. So this was one thing. Apart from these, we see king was a supreme head. He was the head of the judiciary also. So any judgment which is given, the king's judgment was a final judgment. For all the courts, for all the action, king was the supreme head. Also, under the nobility, he is saying that Delhi Sultanate was quite a secular state, where we see that the people of both religion, Hindus as well as Muslims, are getting posts. Mostly the administrative posts were given to the Muslims, but economy of the country were mainly in the hands of the Hindus. So economy was given in the hand of the Hindus, which proves that the ruler, the Sultan, was a very liberal or secular person, not only giving post to the Muslim but also giving post to the Hindus as well. Also, we see that he said that the courts were divided into two parts, that is, civil cases were judged in one court and criminal cases were judged in a separate court. So two courts were there, which was another important nature of the Delhi Sultanate state. Also, he said that for controlling the price of market or for controlling the economy, two division was made in the market, that is the Diwani Riyasat and the Shehnai Mandi. These two officers were kept for controlling prices and for checking the people against price rise. So Diwani Riyasat and Shehnai Mandi were the two very important officer or nobility, group of nobles under the Delhi Sultanate. So this was basically the formation of the nobility or organization of nobility under the Delhi Sultanate. So overall, what idea we can get from Fatwa-e Jahandari is that Delhi Sultanate was not a theocracy, not a theocratic state. It was a secular state where both the Hindus and Muslims coexisted, and both were given a better positions, quite well positioned under the rule of the Sultan or nobles. And another important factor that Ziauddin Barani has clearly stated is that the king or the Sultan should be very careful while selecting the nobles. So we'll keep here for today, and next day we'll do our next topic. Thank you.